It's lively, athletic, it's colorful, but there is a lot more to Ukrainian dance that meets the eye. There are very few who know as much about it as our next guest, Dr. Andriy Nahachewsky. He is here to tell us about his new book, Ukrainian Dance, A Cross-Cultural Approach. Thanks very much for coming in. And I just want to get this straight, that you are a former dancer and choreographer, longtime dancer.
That's right.
And you have authored this book. What drove you to write this book?
Well, I think it's because of how important it is in my life. It's also my research theme. My master's and my doctoral dissertation were on Ukrainian dance and what happens to it, how it changes over the last 100 years.
And how has it changed over the last century?
Well, it's changing. Actually, what it is many different things at the same time. So the ideal, the model is dancing in a village at a wedding 100 years ago, this kind of romantic image. And that's in some senses the core of it. But what's happened over the last 150 years is it's also been revived onto stages. And so when you get people dancing in the Jubilee Auditorium today in Edmonton, it's called Ukrainian dance. And when they were dancing in the village, it's Ukrainian dance too, but they're really different beasts.
So this isn't how they used to dance in Ukrainian villages, or is it somewhat similar to it?
There are bits and pieces that are connected, and these people are kind of pretending that they're in the village. But the form of the dancing, the all kinds of elements of it are very, very different.
Why do you think, and I believe this is Shumka that we're looking at.
Cut is here.
And Shumka celebrating 50 years, more than 50 years.
That's right.
And we just had them on the newscast recently. Why do you think that this form of dance has, sustained itself and has such a great following here, at least in this part of the world?
Yeah, in Canada for sure, there are an estimated 10,000 people doing Ukrainian dancing, and Edmonton happens to be the epicenter. We are the most Ukrainian dance-ish city around, period.
Well, because there's such a large Ukrainian population in this province?
Yeah, but even other cities that have just as many or just as high a percentage of Ukrainians don't have as much Ukrainian dance as we do. I think the reasons why it's so engaging and active and popular is because young people, the dancers, love it. I think their parents really love it. I think audience members really love it. I think there's so much in it for many different constituents of the community that produces it, that's what makes it successful.
This book that you wrote, A Ukrainian Dance, A Cross-Cultural Approach, what kind of wisdom does it impart to those who are interested in this form of dance?
So the main concept that it makes clear is that dancing for recreation, participatory dancing, where really it's about me dancing, it's about my experience, that's really different than dancing on stage in a presentational mode. When you dance for yourself versus when you dance for an audience outside. And that changes the dancing radically.
And one thing that I noticed, you talk about vival dance versus reflective dance. Can you quickly encapsulate what that is?
I think that's related to this. Vival dancing is when I'm dancing for myself here, right now, because it's fun. And reflective dancing is when I'm dancing, but I'm also pretending I'm at another place at another time. So it's kind of in two places and in two times. It's like dancing into a mirror, reflective dance.
Well, some of the most beautiful dancing that I have ever seen, and we love having the Shumka dancers on our show and all Ukrainian dancers on our show. So this, more insight to it that you provide, the book launch for Ukrainian Dance, A Cross-Cultural Approach, is Saturday from 7 to 9 at the Cheremush Studio. We've got more information about the event on our website. Just click onto news links. I was going to say I much enjoy the Cheremush dancers as well. Dr. Andriy Nahachewsky, thank you very much for coming in.
Great, thanks for having me.
And much success with your book.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.